The chainsaw is a highly practical, powerful tool to help you lop, chop and log. And if you've always wanted to add one to your arsenal of gardening tools, but not quite sure where to start, well, don't worry, because in this episode, we'll show you how to assemble, use and maintain your chainsaw to work as safely and efficiently as possible. Which is a good thing, because I am so done with this. Now, before we get started, a quick question for you. The chainsaw was invented in the late 1700s, but by who and what for? Was it A, big burly lumberjacks in order to speed up their lumberjackery? Or B, somebody else? Shout your answers in the comment section down below and we will reveal the answer at the end of the episode. Now, number one, we need to get familiar with our chainsaw. So let's have a quick anatomical breakdown and learn all the different parts of the chainsaw before we start cutting. Quick tour of the chainsaw and show you all the individual elements and what they're called. Now, most recognizable is the bar. These will change in size depending on the application. In this case, we've got a 16-inch bar, which is denoted on the side of the bar. Now, sitting on top of that and around that bar is the chain. That's the business end of your chainsaw. These two components are possibly the most important aspects of the chainsaw and the bits that you need to make sure that you maintain and look after the most. We've got our overhand or loop handle. That allows you as the user to hold firmly on the top of the machine and guide your chainsaw into operation. In front of our loop handle, we have our chain brake. Now this will activate the chain into motion and is possibly the most significant aspect of the chainsaw from both operation and safety. Now I flip this round because I want to show you what's at the bottom of the bar. So you can see these spikes here. This is called your bump stop. And they might look sinister, but they have a very practical application. These allow you to get some additional leverage when you're logging. So you can stab these into the side of the log and then use those when fixed into position to lever your chainsaw, making operation as safe as possible. This is where we will fill our chainsaw with bar oil. It's essential that we keep our chain and bar lubricated throughout use. And this is where you're going to pour your chain oil in. Now, replacing the need for any fossil fuel, fumes, smoke, combustion, heat, pumping and priming. I'm replacing all of that with my 60 volt battery in the top aperture here. So this is our power cell, which will give us all of our power for lopping and chopping. And in order to engage our chainsaw, we have a system of two triggers, one for the thumb, and then our activation trigger underneath the handle here. Now, it's all very well me talking about the key components of a chainsaw when it's already been built. What happens if you get yours delivered and it turns up in a box? And what happens if yours is delivered and it comes in a box? Well, I'll show you a few easy steps to help you assemble your chainsaw at home. Now, we're going to start with the 24 volt chainsaw. Now, this is an entry level chainsaw, great for lopping, general pruning, always essential. We familiarize ourselves with our handbook and our instructions to make sure that we're using our chainsaw safely and effectively. Firstly, we'll see our bar itself. In this case, we've got a 12-inch bar. Bar and chain guard, which we put on to act as a protective sleeve during storage. Now, Oregon chains and bars are a staple when it comes to chainsaws and give us a good pedigree of cut. We'll also find our chainsaw body itself. Now, you might notice that the battery is not on the table. That's because I want to keep my battery away from the chainsaw during assembly. Now, first thing we need to do is open our chain and then we need to unfurl it. But before we do so, make sure you're wearing some gloves because you're essentially handling a cutting implement here. Each one of these teeth is designed to cut, so we want to make sure it cuts the wood, not our fingers and thumbs. If yours is slightly more tangled, just be patient with it and unfurl it so it runs as a single loop. So next up, we need to open our chainsaw. And in this case, we're using a toolless tensioner and toolless socket. So on other chainsaws, you might find that you have two individual locking nuts and a central tightening nut in order to tighten your chain. In this case, we have a single wheel with a removable handle. By twisting, we can unclip the casing on the front and then we can tighten our chain and bar. Now we can remove the housing. Now what you'll notice inside here are the moving components of your chainsaw. So this main wheel is our drive wheel. This is where our chain is going to sit and be driven by the motor. In front of that, you'll notice there's two lugs here. This is going to lock our bar into position, and that is where the bottom of our bar is going to sit over. This coil here is actually the tightening mechanism, and I'll show you how that works shortly. Now, before we fit our chain to our bar, it is critical that we fit the chain in the cutting direction. What do I mean by that? Well, you'll see there's a very distinct shape to the individual tooth. Now, the back, we've got a flat edge, On the front, we've got a very obvious tooth shape. Most chainsaws will show you the direction of travel, and in this case, it's embossed on the side guard here. Can you see? And that's clearly stipulating that we need the longer, broader part of the cutting tooth at the back, and our more obvious tooth needs to go at the front. Slot the chain into the groove which runs around the outside of the bar. Keep pulling back on that chain, pass it over our drive wheel, and then we're going to drop our bar onto that lug. So we've got that lug coming up through the bar. Now remember to keep the tension on, so just move your fingers up the bar and keep that tension running through the chain. That'll keep it locked into position. Now with your free hand, you're just going to drop over the housing, keep that black lever open, and turn in a clockwise direction. This will lock your housing into place on the central locking nut. When you hear the resistance click into position, that's when we're going to close that lever down. And remember that tallest tensioning system I mentioned earlier on? That is the larger green dial. And those satisfying clicks are tightening the chain. Now, optimum tension for your chain is between 3 to 5 millimeters movement away from the bar. We don't want it too tight because that's going to put too much tension on the motor, and we certainly don't want it too loose because then it's flailing everywhere and not performing efficiently enough. Now with our chainsaw assembled, there's one last task. We're going to make sure that we add our chain oil. This lubricant is essential because what happens during usage is that we get a buildup of friction and heat during cutting, so we want to make sure that our chain and bar are kept lubricated. So just like you put oil and lubricate your car engine, we want to keep our bar and chain lubricated for optimum performance and cutting power. Now, if you're not going to be using your chainsaw straight away, that's where the chain and bar guard comes into handy. We can keep that safe and sound in the shed or in the garage. Simultaneously, if you are using it and you want to have a break, make sure you don't leave this exposed, guard on at every opportunity. That way, if you do drop during transit or if you drag it across rough ground, you're not going to damage our cutting teeth. And also, when it comes to storage, make sure you remove your battery. But we are going to get busy cutting, so we need to power up, press on, and get started. Now, fully rigged up, I've got face eye protection, chainsaw trousers, chainsaw gloves, sensible worktop, and safety work boots. And I know I keep going on about safety, but whenever you're using any piece of garden machinery, it's always important that you work as safely as possible. And especially when it comes to using chainsaws, it's worth making sure that we're extra safe before we start. So you'll notice that I've got my log secured at a practical working height. I'm not bending down, I'm not right down to the ground, I'm not on my hands and knees, and I'm certainly not throwing the chainsaw around at height. It's a good practical working platform, and it's locked into position as well. Now, it's also important that my work environment is safe as well. So I've got no distractions. The kids aren't out in the garden. They've been locked away. They're watching Peppa Pig in the living room. They haven't been locked away. You'll also notice that I've got a good open work environment. Nothing around my feet, nothing to trip over. No cords, no cables. That's the virtue of using battery power, is that I don't have to keep constantly tugging at a cord or a cable, or worse still, have to worry about cutting through it. And the other advantage as well is that I'm making less noise with a battery powered machine. So whereas a petrol engine would be rattling away, creating its own sound effects and drama, recorder's cutting convenience. Less noise means I can keep my ear out as well as my eyes for anything that does move into my work environment. Finally, it's down to operating. That's all about being competent and confident with your chainsaw. A good confident grip on both handles. I'm right-handed, so I've got my right hand on the lower handle, left hand on the top handle. So now I can position my chainsaw. But how do I activate? Well, there's two triggers, as we mentioned earlier on. One for my thumb, I depress that. And on the underside trigger, we can use our finger, but it didn't start. Why is that? Well, remember the chain brake I mentioned earlier on? Think of this almost like the brakes on a car. This is gonna stop the cutting mechanism. So at the moment, my brake is locked off, so I can't activate the cutting chain. I pull this back and repeat the same trigger process. As soon as I lock the brakes into position, I'll pull the brakes on the chain. And that's a safety feature as well, because if you're cutting into a timber or if you're cutting into a branch and all of a sudden you get a kickback, it's to protect you from the kickback and deactivate the unit straight away.
Now it's time to power up and cut down.
really not that exciting, and it shouldn't be. It should be sensible and it should be safe. So we need to identify where we want to cut. Once we've done that, bring our bar up to where we intend to make our cut through the log. Now, the idea is that you're going to lift the chainsaw away, you're going to power up, and you're going to keep that power going all the way through as you make your cut. Ideally, you want to bring the body of the chainsaw as close to the log as possible. This is going to mean that you're going to optimize the cutting angle, and you're also going to avoid kickback. When you finish your cut, straight away, hit the chain brake to deactivate the unit. This is what it should look like. Now remember, we're not toppling trees or felling forests. Leave that to the professionals. This tool is all about helping us make logging a leisurely exercise, taking away all that effort and energy required when manually sawing. So whether you're battling branches or lopping logs, let the tool do the work for you. Well, hopefully this video has helped you become a little bit more familiar with the chainsaw and maybe taken away some of those nerves or trepidation you had about owning and operating one. Really useful tool to have in your array of garden machinery, especially if, like me, you have logs of work to do in your garden. Now, whatever you're up to in your garden this week, I hope you have a tremendous time. And don't forget, if you are thinking about investing in a chainsaw to help you on your way in your garden, you can always check out the link at the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Oh, and by the way, in answer to our question earlier, if you had voted option A, lumberjacks, then congratulations. To all of those who have voted B, because it was in fact doctors who invented the chainsaw back in the 18th century. Personally, I'm glad we've come a long way since then. Hope you enjoyed that pointless piece of information.